If you don't have an external MIDI controller, or would just like a software alternative to one, then the Instrument MIDI Control device can be used to send MIDI messages directly to the plugin and MIDI components of a Renoise instrument. As an effect device, it also has the advantage of being easy to control and automate. The top option is used to select the instrument that this device is targeting, chosen from those available in the instrument selector. Aside from this, all of the other sets of parameters work in exactly the same way. Initially, only four sets of these parameters are displayed, but the small arrow button in the bottom right corner will expand the device to show more, up to 35, which is the maximum that can be addressed via effect commands. The slider alters the value that is sent, while the MIDI message type is changed with the drop-down menu, which changes both the parameter name and the function of this option. For pitch bend, channel pressure, and program change messages, it works as an on-off toggle. But when the message type is set to controller change, it becomes a value box, specifying the CC number that is sent. Likewise, the parameter name is automatically set for these three messages. But when the type is set to controller change, clicking on the text allows a custom name to be entered, usually for identifying what the specific CC message number does. In addition to the standardized controller change numbers, plugin and MIDI instruments often have customized sets of numbers, and you'll typically find information about them in the instrument's reference manual. For full details of the CC messages supported directly through Renoise, see the MIDI section of the online manual. Normally, this device only affects the plugin and MIDI components of an instrument, but it is possible to affect samples in a few different ways. First, program change messages also affect the instrument's phrase. Next, if the instrument is purely sample-based, then changing the volume, scale key, and scale mode via their CC numbers will adjust those parameters in the instrument properties. If the instrument contains plugin and/or MIDI components though, then the messages will be directed there instead. And lastly, the MIDI controllers to the left of the on-screen keyboard are also automated by any pitch bend, channel pressure, or CC01 messages, making it possible to affect samples through their macros. If you're unfamiliar with setting those up, then check out our previous video on the subject. There's a few other things worth pointing out here, just so that you're aware of them. By default, this device has only one preset, used to quickly start working with a general MIDI instrument. But if you make use of this device a lot, then it'll be worthwhile setting up and saving your own custom presets for your favourite instruments, some of which may actually be in other audio programs. Because if you're using Rewire with Renoise as the master, then the Instrument MIDI Control device can be used to control the instruments of other applications. And you may have noticed that there's no parameter to change the MIDI channel number here. This is due to the fact that the plugin and MIDI components of a Renoise instrument set their channel numbers independent of each other. And, as you may have seen demonstrated in the first part of the Using Plugins series, some plugins can even make use of multiple channels through their external editor. And finally, when a song is loaded that contains one or more instrument MIDI control devices, they will immediately send out messages from all of the enabled parameters. This is necessary to prepare the song for playing with the correct settings, but it may not be ideal for your particular setup. In this case, you should use automation to initially start with the device disabled.